for inviting me as the chief guest to the annual dinner of the District Bar Association Hyderabad. As the Chief Justice of Pakistan, the District Bar Association Hyderabad is the first bar that has conferred on me an honor to come and participate in the annual dinner. As a lawyer, I had an occasion of working in the district courts of Hyderabad, so also before the bench of the High Court of Hyderabad. It gave me an occasion to meet with the members of the District Bar Association Hyderabad, and really from my heart, I say that they were and are great people, and I always relished my visit to Hyderabad. Even as a member of the bench of High Court, I have always relished working at Hyderabad, and to tell you frankly, I really felt in love with the city of Hyderabad. I will go about and visit the city of Hyderabad, not in a car, but by walking, and I appreciate the people, so also the architecture of the historical city. Hyderabad city has a great history, and I remember that ancient name of the city was Naran Court. This was told to me by Mr. Ghulam Rabbani, my Lord Mr. Justice Ghulam Rabbani, and it got stuck in my head. I was really impressed by the two forts of Hyderabad, one known as Pakka Kila and other as Kacha Kila, besides many other marvelous and absorbing places. River Indus is the lifeline of the city, and I have spent much of my time contemplating sitting on its bank and even on Phuleli Canal. The city, its people have a great tradition by all means. Ladies and gentlemen, the legal profession is very noble, and all who are sitting here are most learned people and cream of the society. They are in tandem with the pillar of justice and most important pillar of the city, of the country, and ensure that the citizens do get their share of justice as they right to get. Such working of the lawyer fraternity is not just an ehsaan on the people, but it is sacred duty which they perform in ensuring that real justice is done to the persons whom they represent in the court of law. Equally, the court have been established and judges perform their functions of dispensing justice, which is the divine duty cast upon them from Almighty Allah, and in doing so, they are to ensure that each person get what is due to him under the law and the constitution of the country. Out of the Holy Quran and Sunnah, the most sacred book available to the people of Pakistan is the Constitution of Pakistan. Such constitution the people have given to themselves through their chosen representatives in the parliament, and it is not just the function of the court or the lawyer to ensure that such sacred document is protected by it. Is also the function of the people to see protected, and all things are done according to its mandate. The Constitution has a mechanism to provided in it whereby the life of each of the individual citizen of Pakistan could be elevated from the abject despondency to the cherished happiness, well-being and prosperity. It is the only unwillingness of the functionaries which has become the stumbling block in the achievement of the goals provided in the Constitution. The law of country, which is the Constitution, and other law frame under it, ensure delivery of equal right and opportunities to all citizens for education, health, prosperity, and well-being. And it is with great concern that we note people are not getting real benefit of such laws, in that the education and health sectors and opportunities of dignified living are not being provided to the people, which is not only grave injustice, but affecting the very fabric of the society. A serious note in this regard has to be taken by the administration. Ensure that all basic and fundamental rights, opportunities are given due effect and application, and cherished goal provided in the Constitution are achieved. The founder of the country, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, the Qaid-e-Azam, has laid down many of the principles of governance in his speeches, after the independence of the country, for the glory of the country, but as it is prevailing, as is the prevailing situation, all such good things have been forgotten and have been put on the shelves. In my estimation, it is rather to be taken out of the shelves and at every level to be taught and inculcated in the people. Ladies and gentlemen, the country has a great potential, not only in the manpower, but also in natural resources. By mixing the two, the country can achieve and become the most prosperous country in the region. But as is always the case, the administration does not either has the capacity or will to harness both, nor cares to evolve plans for achieving this objective. I do call upon those who all matters in the country to ensure that the people are delivered what they are entitled to under the law, and disparity between have and have not should immediately be addressed. It is a fundamental right of every citizen of the country to be dealt with in accordance with law, and law does provide equal sharing of the resources of to each according to his ability and according to his work. Ladies and gentlemen, let me assure that the courts in Pakistan shall always ensure dispensation of justice in accordance with law and give to the people their legal rights. Bench and the bar have been assigned this wondrous duty, and both their mutual effort will ensure deliverance to the people. Such holy alliance of the bench and the bar could make it possible to see that the people of the country have happiest, prosperous life, and they are provided by proper civic and civil infrastructure by the government, where they can build upon their lives and that of their families. The holy alliance of the bench and the bar will never be compromised. In the end, I wish Godspeed to the District Bar Association and the bar in its all future endeavors for ensuring rule of law, protection of constitution, and independence of judiciary. Thank you very much. Pakistan, Zindabad.